Alright, we're keeping this hand, of course. And he goes land pass. Just go ahead and fetch a mountain. And play a Swift Spear. Force him to have that bolt. He's got the bolt. Okay. Force him to have another bolt, or a remand, or something. Just getting the mountain here, we can just get a white source with the Scalding Tarn. Alright, looks like he did have the remand after all. Yeah, this is definitely one of those situations where, yeah, if he has turn 3, kill you. Turn 3 guide, turn 4, kill you, then good beats. Looks like he doesn't have it. I'm assuming it's a Serum Visions. No, it's a Thought Scour. Okay. Alright, Eidolon. Stop! Alright, I'm getting a white source here. And I will choose to suspend the Rift Bolt. Please stop. Please. I haven't resolved the spell yet. Oh no, I had the Swift Spear. Never mind. A Snapcaster remand or something? Oh, negate. Okay. I feel like I want to use a burn spell here first. So let's try to deal 4 to him. Got all the counter spells. Alright. I wanted to play that first before playing the Eidolon. So I don't take any damage. Like, the Azure Charm was going to get something, so. Guess we'll attack. Yeah, we'll spike him. I could have gotten a Sacred Foundry. I didn't anticipate drawing so many of the red white cards. Now we're like kind of choked on our mana. Is it Tarmogoyf? Okay. Take 4. Yeah, I'm not going to attack. This is interesting. Can try to resolve one of my spells right now. The question is, do I want it to be Helix or do I want it to be Boros Charm? Helix makes it so that it's much safer for me, much less likely to die, because it'll put me at 11, and then I played Eidolon putting me at 9. Now if I play the Boros Charm and get him down to 2, I'll go to 8. Then if I play Eidolon, I'll go to 6. If he Cryptic Commands my team and then bolts me, then it'll tie. I'm leaning towards Boros. Let's see. I think Helix might be the safer play. Well, The problem is if I go with the Helix, he can play like a Exarch and then just combo me off and kill me as well. Which is probably unlikely for it. Like it's very unlikely that he actually has the combo here. If he casts Snapcaster Bolt, no, then he just dies. So if I cast Lightning Helix, and then he makes... Alright, you know what? We'll just do that. If it resolves, he can't actually play any other spells, so... Then we'll just play an Eidolon too. Tarmogoyf. Can't play anything. Alright, we got him! We got a match win. Okay, so I posted an extra video just because I felt bad because of the poor performance of the deck so far, but like I said before, I do think this deck is solid. I'm still learning how to play the deck optimally. We're changing the deck. This deck's actually harder than it looks. You might think you can just, yeah, lava spike you, bolt you, bolt you, bolt you, but sequencing your spells is very important. Figuring out what lands to get when is also important, and holding back lands for Searing Blaze is also, of course, important. But here you have it, 5 rounds of burn. Next video I plan on posting is going to be on Blue-Red Splinter Twin, which is something I'm far more comfortable playing. Thanks for watching, guys, and now for sure I will see you guys. I'll have another video up within a week or so. Woo!